In part one of our lesson on solving right triangles, you're going to learn about significant digits and accuracy of measurements. When you're rounding in a calculation, your answer can be no more accurate than the least accurate number used in the calculation. So accuracy only gets worse as you go on and on and on calculating. It can't get better. This is similar to a chain. Maybe you've heard the expression, a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. So if you have a chain that has 6 links in it, and 5 of those links would each hold 1,000 pounds, but one of those links only holds 50 pounds, then that chain is going to break the minute you put something on there that weighs 51 pounds, because even though the rest of the links could hold 1,000 pounds each, that 50-pound link is going to break at 51 pounds. So it's a similar idea with accuracy in your calculation. So let's take a look at how this would work when we solve a problem and have to do a calculation. So in this example, we're going to solve for x. We see that we have right triangle XYZ, and we know when we have a right triangle, we can use the Pythagorean theorem. So we have to take the sum of the squares of the legs. Now, y is the right angle, so that means the side labeled x and the side labeled 5.2 are the legs. So we can take x squared plus 5.2 squared is equal to 6.97 squared. Now we're trying to solve for x, so we'll subtract the 5.2 squared. I'm not going to do this intermediate calculation. I'm just going to leave it as 5.2 squared for right now. So the right-hand side becomes 6.97 squared minus 5.2 squared. On the left-hand side, we have x squared, which means we're going to take the square root of both sides. And x is going to be the square root of 6.97 squared minus 5.2 squared. Now, we don't put a plus or minus in front of this one, even though the square root's property would tell us to do that, because we know that x is the length of a side of a triangle, and it absolutely positively has to be positive. All right, now at this point, we would pick up our calculators and do this calculation. So we'll hit the second key. Then we'll hit the x squared button because above it is square root. Enter our 6.97, hit the squared key, minus 5.2, hit the squared key, close your parentheses, and then hit enter. So now we have to decide what decimal place we're going to round to. And as we look at the numbers in our calculation, we see 6.97 has 3 significant digits, and 5.2 has 2 significant digits. So we're going to have to round, and our answer can have 2 significant digits, which in this case means we're rounding to the tenths place. We can't go on to the hundredths place because 5.2 doesn't have a hundredths place. So we're going to have to round x to be 4.6. Next, I want to help make sure you understand how it works when measurements are rounded. If we have an answer that has been rounded to 18, which is to the nearest ones place, then that means the smallest possible measurement that could have been made is 17.5, because we know that the 5 in the tenths place would tell the 7 to go up to become an 8. Now, the largest possible measure that could have been made, we know is going to be 18. We know that the biggest number in the tenths place could be a 4, but that's not the biggest number we could have because there could be decimal places after that. So they could be as big as 9 going on forever. As long as there's a 4 in the tenths place, that 4 will tell the 8 to stay the same, and it would round to be 18. One of the tools we use is we look at the difference between the actual value and the measurement. Now, difference between two numbers is a subtraction, and that number could be positive or negative, so we're going to take the absolute value of the difference between our measurement, let's call it x, because it varies. X is going to vary between 17.5 all the way up to a possible 18.4999 repeating. We take the difference between x and the value that we want, which is 18, and we say that that has to be less than or equal to 0.5. If our answer was rounded to 18.0, then that means we rounded to the tenths place, which means then we have to use the hundredths place to decide whether the tenths place should stay the same or increase by 1. So the smallest possible value that we could have is 17.95. because the 5 tells the 9 to become a 10, and the 1 carries over and tells the 7 to become an 8. Now, the largest possible value we could have is 18.04, and then anything after that could be anything. It could be as big as 9. But the 4 tells the 0 to stay put. So then the difference between our actual value and the measurement, x minus 18.0, has to be less than or equal to 0.05. Okay, why don't you try this one, the 18.00. You try filling in these boxes now, and then restart the video when you're ready to check your answer. We know if we're rounding to the hundredths place, then that means we were having to look at the thousandths place to make that decision. So it could be as small as 17.995, right? You see the 5 tells the 9 to become a 10, which carries over, tells this 9 to become a 10, which carries over and tells the 7 to become an 8. And it could have been as large as 18.0049, repeating, because this 4 in the thousandths place tells the 0 in the hundredths place to stay put. So when we look at the difference, we have x minus 18.00 has to be less than or equal to 0.005.